liked his reaction.
Yeah.
All kinds of heavy gauge, high caliber guns going off. Gas handgun. I sent a 20 slug downrange. What the hell is that?
Hi. Been a while.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Sorry.
But we're here to update you on the goings on.
So about a month ago, we were coming home from our friend's 40th birthday party in Vermont. And I was driving on Interstate 89, and the Subaru just stopped working. All the lights just came on, started flashing on the dash, and turns out that one of the cylinders failed in the engine, and we had to take it in to get evaluated, and insurance took forever, and we've been without a car for a month now, but yeah. One of our very kind friends, one of the many wonderful people we're blessed to have in our on our lives, lent us their Bronco, which we're in right now, and gave us their blessing to go to Maine. So
yeah,
guess what? We're in Maine. Again,
yes.
For the first time since, I think, mid-January,
yeah.
It's been a while, yeah, because our car broke down right before we were going to go to Maine.
Yeah. Yeah, literally the weekend before, we had already taken off time, planned the whole nine yards. We were ready to go, but it didn't happen that way.
Yeah.
But we're not going to the property this time. We're here for a different reason. We're at Kittery Trading Post.
We are at Kittery Trading Post, and I am hopefully going to buy a Beretta A300 Ultima to take turkey hunting with me, because I was selected for a Massachusetts State turkey hunting training program. It's for novice turkey hunters and has a really long waiting list, so I was very, very fortunate to be selected. And it includes a seminar on March 30th where they kind of go over everything you need to know about turkey hunting, including patterning your gun. And you have to bring your gun with you that you intend to hunt with. Yep. And the hunt is in May. I need a gun for the end of March, so here we are.
Yep. I'm going to pick this up, and then we're going to go to White Birch Armory over in New Hampshire. We're going to get the turkey choke and some turkey ammunition. And while we're there, so she can practice just shooting a shotgun.
Yeah.
She's yet to be able to shoot her own shotgun. It's not the first time she shot a gun at all, but it's going to be her first time with a shotgun like this. So,
actually, it is the first time I've shot a shotgun. I've only shot handguns and rifles before.
Well, there you go.
So,
first time with a shotgun.
Yes.
So we're going to get some rounds through this one just so she can feel familiar with using the gun, you know, safely loading it, unloading it, etc. Meanwhile, we've also brought her slug gun.
The Winchester SX4 buck model.
Yep. So we brought the slug gun. I'm going to put a few rounds through the slug gun and clean it out just to start breaking in that barrel. Hasn't had a shot down it yet.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So I'm excited.
Yeah, I am too. Oh, also we got certified. We got CPR AED first yep. aid certified.
Yep.
Two weeks ago. That was an interesting experience.
Yeah, that was fun. But it was necessary so we can continue the process of getting our main guide license.
Yes. Now
Looking
we just need
to
train. We need to train for the exam.
Yep. Practice for that exam and then get signed up for it. So
yeah.
We'll see
yeah.
how long that's going to take. That's another step. Now, for the biggest news is what's going on with the property and us building on a homestead in Maine. So we've settled on a floor plan. We like
the
floor plan.
First of all, we're building a cabin.
Yeah, we're definitely going to be building a cabin.
Hopefully this year.
A floor plan. We like the floor plan. Working all that kind of stuff out with which log home supplier we're going to use. We know that we want cedar logs, so that narrows that down real quick. And mm-hmm. we want it local, so that narrows it down even further. I think it's like three.
There's a few. There's a few to choose from. It's one of the great things about New England.
It is.
Eric's going to be the GC because mm-hmm. he used to build houses for a living. So this is kind of his wheelhouse.
Yeah, I look forward to doing this again. So yeah. A lot of that's the easy part. We still have to find somebody to do some site work and put in the foundation crawl space, because we're going to put this on a crawl space. So we've got that figured out as far as we really need to for now, because what everything hinges on is figuring out our septic. So we bought the property. It's got a well. We can find a well. That's the easy part. I don't know if it's running yet, but that can be worked on. But we can locate it. What we can't locate yet is the septic. and like refreshing a well, putting a new pump on, that kind of thing. That's easy peasy compared to if the septic's bad. So, but that's going to be the next step here in the next month or so. As the ground thaws out, we can go up there poking around. Best case scenario is we find a septic tank. We can unearth a septic tank easily. We can find the pipes that go out to the field. And hopefully that's all clean or usable or, you know, refurbishable. Because there's sometimes you can do like remediation that like it's not usable the way it is. But if you clean out like some roots and dirt and stuff, you can. Worst case scenario is we can't find it. There is not one. Or we have to like just rip it out and put an entire new system in. So to that end, I found a septic inspector that can come out when the ground gets warm. I found a site evaluator to come out in case we need a new system drawn up or need this one permitted, you know, for the LUPC.
Because neither the septic nor the well were permitted when they were put in, and we don't know anything about them because of that. There's nothing on file.
Right. So we have talked to the LUPC office, and there's no permits.
There's nothing
on this property at all whatsoever for anything. So there's no record of the well, no record of the septic, no record of the house. Now the neighbors, like the three generation long neighbors who have been there for the last 50 years will tell you there was a house there. There was a couple there. There was, you know, so on and so forth. And it
burned
down.
The neighbors know more than the LUPC.
Right. The neighbors know the goings on there. So,
we're going to have to talk to them because they have some pretty valuable knowledge. So.
But that's really, we can't do anything. Oh, and I've got the number for the local plumbing inspector, which would have to come out to inspect the tie-ins for the well and the septic when they reach the cabin. There's a couple things you do have to get looked at, even out in the territory. But that's where we're at with that. We're kind of just holding our breath, kind of looking at figuring out like where we're going to buy cabinets, hardware, you know, light fixtures, tile, that kind of stuff. Just kind of occupying our time figuring out some of that stuff while we wait for it to get warm so we can figure out the septic. It's made it so our budget has ballooned quicker than expected.
The septic definitely added a lot.
That septic definitely adds a huge one to it. And just also do your research, y'all. I'm telling you, do your research, because there's things out there that are advertised one way, and when you really start to dig into the fine print, you'll realize what it is. Like a log home package from this place for $50,000 for a whole kit is much different than the log home package from this place for $100,000, and you soon find out what that $50,000 is worth.
There's a reason why it's half the price,
and it's worth it to pay them more.
It's worth it to pay a little more, especially if it's going to be four season.
Yeah, especially if this is your going to be forever home. So yeah, we're finding out real quick, you know, some of the realities of it, but not dissuaded, not stopping, making it happen.
Yeah, we're definitely, we're trying to move through, I guess, as they say in Dungeons and Dragons, difficult terrain. And, yes. You know, just trying to move through it at more than half speed. but it's just part of the journey. We're just moving forward. And you know, while we're waiting for the ground to thaw, I thought it would be nice to go buy a firearm and go to the shooting range. So are you ready to go?
I am.
Go buy a shotgun? Yeah, let's go.
Thank y'all for your patience. Yeah, it's been an exercise in patience for us. It's been driving us crazy to not have a car, not creating videos.
Yeah.
Yeah, not being able to do stuff to create a video to update you guys to keep you going along. So
yeah, thank you to those of you who reached out asking where we are.
Yes,
that's so flattering to know that you guys are following us along and you're interested in our journey. That really means so much. So
yeah, thank you for that. But we haven't given up.
No,
we have not given up.
No, we're just hibernating for the winter.
Exercising frustrating patience.
Yes, we're coming out of hibernation. Hopefully we'll have our car back in like 2 weeks. So but for now we have this awesome Bronco, and that allowed us to come here today, and let's head into Kittery Trading Post. All right, I love this bear.
Let's go up and get it.
Hello.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. Come on in.
You're going upstairs.
I'm upstairs. That's a nice gun safe. Ooh. Had a moose on it.
Nice safe.
Look at this guy. Yeah, guns down over here. This place is huge.
There's so many goodies in here.
Yeah, they do have good gear here.
Ooh, DS2. Look at that. Oh, women's hunting apparel.
Oh my God, it's all women's hunting stuff.
Shout out to DSG.
Yeah, I love this brand.
It was something good.
Yeah.
I've gotten her into DSG with a couple of things I got her for Christmas. That's how she got introduced to the brand.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I'm a fan. Yeah. Oh my God, they have so much women's stuff. Yeah.
Nice.
Guns. Ammo. Oh yeah. I just found my Beretta. Eric is drooling over everything.
They're baking something in here and it smells delicious and it's got me fucking watering
every time,
at the mouth.
Every time, they're always baking something. I think it's like, what is it? It's the popcorn.
There's no way that's the popcorn.
Yeah, last time we were here, you were like, what is that smell? And it was popcorn.
It smells like a cinnamon bun.
It does smell like cinnamon bun. So, got a shotgun. I just have to go to the counter and finish the transaction, but we're looking at turkey vests because I'm gonna need a turkey vest.
They don't have it.
All right, we'll go we'll online. What's going online?
We're calling for good. We got the things that are absolutely necessary for the gun.
Safety gear, sling, and look at this amazing
nice little boy harness.
Used soft case.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Like brand new ones over there. They have the
brand new ones. Yeah, the brand new ones are much more expensive, but someone traded that in and it's really good condition. So
this is
the new version of
yep
the used one that we're getting. How much is that?
Brand new. It is $92.
$92, and the used one we're getting is like $30.
$35.
So, yeah. Eric's trying to go bass fishing. Catch and release, of course.
There's no other type of lure that catches them as consistently across seasons and across conditions like a jig does. Just grab a couple of these tails, and
we're off to New Hampshire. Yeah. All right.
Now we're gonna go to White Birch Armory and spend more money. I mean, we're gonna go shoot guns.
Eric got his fishing gear. I got my turkey hunting gear. We also got some turkey targets, which are photoreactive, which is pretty cool. But yeah, now we're off to New Hampshire. We're gonna go to shooting range. I have to get some choke tubes and some ammo. Check this out. You ready to shoot, baby?
Heck yeah. Whenever you're ready, lean into it. Safety off. I saw the paper flinch every time you slung it. You know, a handful of rounds per shot. So, how you feel? Was that fun? Let's do some more.
Slug gun? Oh no shit. Caught me off guard.
Yeah, with all the others thumping in here, I thought that was funny as hell.
Wait, what's that? Just a 20 gauge?
Yeah,
Yeah, let's go. She's going down there. Oh yeah, she did. I have a dead center. Let's do it again.
All right, shot both guns. They did great.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely prefer the Beretta, I have to say. This is a little less recoil. SX4 is an incredibly powerful gun. I would definitely feel comfortable going deer hunting with that.
A slug gun only, puts it in.
The only problem was when I fired the SX4 each time, I felt like my contacts were going to come out of my eyeballs. I felt like I was going to lose my contacts out of my eyeballs. So I was like, and also it was really heavy, and I had already been holding up the Beretta before that, and my arm was just getting tired. I was like, Eric, you got to finish out this round. So it's a heavy gun, and I don't have a lot of upper body strength. I'm a small human, and I don't lift weights. So, well, the Beretta, I really didn't have any issue with the recoil in the Beretta. Like, that was...
Yeah.
Actually,
pretty smooth.
Yeah, it was really smooth.
It was smooth.
It was the SX4. That's a very powerful firearm, and I literally felt like the contacts were going to come flying out of my eyeballs.
Couldn't pattern turkey gun. Can't shoot any trap shot. Can't do anything like that. But your first shotgun shooting, and you got to shoot bow slug and smooth bore. How are you feeling?
I definitely prefer outdoor ranges. The noise in there, there were a lot of people in there, and some of them had really, really loud guns. And
they got some high caliber stuff going on in there today. So
yeah, and there were people on both sides. Like, we were on lane number 2. There were people on lane number 1 and 3. So they're like right next to us, and
you could feel it.
You could feel everything happening in there. Yeah. And I'm not used to an indoor range. I'm not used to that level of noise. So the noise plus the vibrations just constantly going off I turned to Eric. I was like, I gotta take a break from this. I can't do this.
Yeah, I felt bad.
My ears.
Yeah.
I got a turkey choke tube.
Mm-hmm.
And also we got some ammo for that. Yeah, we got some turkey shot. So can't pattern it here. So we're going to pattern it on our land.
We'll share all the details and specs of the loads that we shot and whatnot in the description.
I'll put it in the description, yeah. Yeah, I mean, otherwise, I thought they're great guns. I can't wait to fire them outdoors.
And you're officially a shotgunner. Let's go.
Ah.
Well, for now, we're going to go get something to eat and then head on back and get these things cleaned up.
Yeah.
Start planning for next weekend.
Yeah, hopefully we'll see you again soon. Bye. From New Hampshire this time. Bye.